Amen. Of the latter rain, and it talks is still falling. It is still pouring down. But there are things you need to do to position yourself on that rain to come into your spirit, to come upon your life. Jesus said, out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. When it flows, the Bible says that when the living water is flowing, when it comes anywhere that are dead things, the things become alive.
Amen.
Are you getting me? So when nobody succeeds, a man under rainfall in the kingdom succeeds. When everybody is crying, you are not crying. Because the rainfall of the kingdom is not determined by economies or scientists. If you were scientists, say that we don't rainfall, you are experiencing tremendous rain. Are you understanding me? When economy says everything is down, you are so surprised. Why are things down? Why are people crying? Because our access is unlimited. The kingdom treasure has no boundary. Look at someone says it's time. It's time. Shake someone and say it's time. It's time. It's time. It's time. It's time. It's time. And we'll say three things. Three things we said this morning, which I will just repeat it very fast because God has been impressing that from my spirit says. We said for the rain to fall, you need to accumulate the rain in the sky. There can be no rainfall without accumulation. And accumulation is a sowing. Sowing in three dimensions. Sowing your time to his service, your time to in his presence. You can't be too busy, because if you are too busy, rain does not fall on busy people. Hello?
Hi.
I'm speaking to somebody. Rain fall on those who invest time in his presence. He said, if you believe, out of your belly shall flow rivers of living water. We're talking about sowing yourself. You can't just be a passenger in the church. You have to sow yourself for the work. Sow yourself for the service of God. What are you doing for the Lord? You are scrambling to do the work of God. Because it is an eternal investment. You can't regret it. God does not pour his rain on somebody who has no value in his kingdom. Am I speaking to somebody here?
Yes.
Let me talk about showing yourself that, which is so important to accumulate your financial return. It's so important.
Amen. Right.
You have to sow to the level where you get to the Isaac sacrifice. You know, if God carries from above to the Isaac sacrifice, we will run the way. How many people are talking about the Isaac sacrifice? He's talking about the ultimate one that values so much to your God, so give it for his own. Hello? Look at someone saying, you need to move up. You need to move up. I thought you were saying, you need to move up. He says, give it for his work. This is the ultimate. I was listening, a man who gave a testimony how they were doing ministry, and they had just, they struggled and bought a bus to be carrying them from one place to another because they were doing evangelical ministry. And one day while they were in prayers, God said, I seek sacrifice. And the man said, what am I doing? And God said, that boss, God gave them a ministry. Take the boss to that ministry. And God says, don't give me a lame sacrifice or a sacrifice that is defiled. So to the man said, God told him, God says, take the boss to the mechanic. Repair the bus, put new parts, respray the bus, and write the name of the ministry on the bus. They take it to them. Some of you give God a lot of lame offerings, up in the last city. Hello. So the man took the box, because that was a miracle. He was crying because he was losing the horse. And the pastor told him that just 5 minutes ago, they were just praying for God to provide them a bus for the mission field. So he gave that bus and came back to the house. And he was waiting for God to provide them a bigger bus. He stayed 1 year, 2 years, the remote of no bus. Because some of you think that the problem is when you give, you begin to expect. When God opened doors, his international ministry was launched. They began to move from one nation to another. So the Lord told him, I took away that bus to give you access to a plane. Somebody hearing me?
Yes, sir.
Then someone said, don't joke with sowing. I said, don't joke with sowing. Why am I preaching on this? Because if you don't do it, it is impossible to explode in the time and season of the Lord. He said, when God opened doors, he went to South Africa. He preached, he came back the next day, he went to Israel, came back the next 2 days, he went to US, came back, until he sat and was crying. He said, God, it is too much, I can't cope with it. Hello?
Right.
That's what we're talking about. He said, when you sow, you don't count it, you don't take the clouds. You allow it to germinate. And you see how God opened different doors in your life.
Amen.
Hello.
Amen.
Look at somebody, say this time.
This time.
I'm not going to say this time.
This time.
Now let me finish his testimony. The testimony is almost his time. Now he said, when God opened him doors for his first mission field, it was to the UK. They invited him to minister in the UK. He went to minister there. He had all the money in his pocket. He converted it into pounds. Because he went there with his wife, he knew that they were going to live with that money. And so when they fell around, the Lord told him that when you get into the church, give all that money for offerings. Brother, you need to walk in the Spirit of God. So he said, they went into the church, you look at the wife, and they came and dropped everything in the offering basket. And it was so funny that that church collected offering 3 times. And the first time he dropped all the money. So the offering basket kept on passing, and there was no money to give again. But what he dropped the first time was even 3 times more than the whole offering of the church. Praise God. So when they finished their mission there, he came, he was leaving that place with about 4 or 5 times what he had that God blessed him. So he was happy with what they had, a lot of thousands of pounds. So they were happy. As they landed back in their country, the Lord told him, this money is not for you. I don't know. He said, what? The Lord said, this is your first mission field.